there is a sort of politics and a reality that are often in conflict. Most people with mental illnesses, most people with autism, most people with any of this variety of conditions, which we largely describe as brain diseases of one kind or another, will never hurt anyone. If we talk too much about those dangerous situations, we stigmatize people we shouldn't. If we take a politically correct standpoint and we don't acknowledge those situations, then we end up with families in which a child is terrifying and violent and nobody believes them and they don't understand what it is they have to deal with. It's a very fine balance we need to strike.
I think what we forget most of all when someone is violent and when they have a serious mental illness is that we've failed them. It's a little bit like if someone had diabetes and they go into coma. That's part of the illness, right? But if they get treated, that should never happen, if they get treated well. And that's where we've let people down.
We need to understand that treatment before tragedy is not only possible, but it should become our reality. And it's going to take some tough conversations. This is about helping people who are suffering. And we know that if we can get children treatment, we can change the whole course, not only of a child's life, but of an entire family's life.
Oh, over here. Look. What kind of penguins are there? Hi, penguin.
I wish one of them was going
to. Come on, watch.
Absolutely.
Look, I see one over there. Good afternoon.
It's always polite to say that.
You want a taste?
You're welcome.
I wouldn't go to heaven if I didn't share. If I don't share, I can't go to heaven. No, I can't, actually. Well, it's, you know why? Because in hell, they're controlling you. Here, you want me to hold yours?
Well, that's very nice of you, Ethan.
Here, let me see. You want?
Sorry.
Oh, I think you want to play with it?